Draw the projections of the following points on the same xy line, keeping convenient distance between each projectors. Name the quadrants in which they lie. Capital E is 30 mm below HP and 25 mm behind VP. Capital F, 35 mm below HP and 30 mm in front of VP. Capital G, on HP and 30 mm in front of VP. Capital H, on HP and 35 mm behind VP. So first, we will going to draw a common XY line and you mark HP and VP. Now we are in a position to analyze this without writing the three-dimensional sketches. Here, the 30 mm below HP, so the below HP will going to come into the picture only in third quadrant and fourth quadrant. So that means it will be below HP will always be below XY line. So we can say first we will going to draw a vertical thin projector line and 30 mm below HP. So from XY line, from this point you measure 30 mm and mark this point. Since it is below HP, the image will going to be on the vertical plane. Since it is on the vertical plane, it is A dash. So you mark the point as A dash. And 25 mm behind VP. Behind VP will always comes above XY line. So obviously it should be from here. You measure 25 mm above the XY line and mark this point. And this point we will call it as E. So E give the dimension of 25 mm and 30 mm, which is as shown. Then the answer will be, so below HP, behind VP, so means the point E, capital E, lies in third quadrant. So point capital E lies in fourth quadrant, third quadrant. Next is capital F. Now, keeping convenient distance between each projector. So from here to here, you take any convenient distance and draw a vertical projector line, thin line. Then again, capital F, 35 mm below HP. So below HP will always comes below XY line. So from here you measure the distance of 35 mm and you mark this point, which is F dash. So this should be dash, F dash, because it is below HP, the image will be on vertical plane. Since the image is on vertical plane, obviously this should be the front view. So this will be F dash and 30 mm in front of VP. In front of VP will always comes below XY line. So again, you measure from the XY line a distance of 30 mm and you mark this point, and this point you mark it as F, which is the top view, because in front of VP will always falls on HP. Since the image is on HP, obviously that should be the top view. Since it is below HP and in front of VP, so capital F lies in fourth quadrant. Capital G on HP and 30 mm in front of VP. So on HP means it will be on XY line. So always on HP or on VP, always the point will be on XY line. So on HP means it will be on the XY line. So you mark the point. To name it, on HP means it will be on VP. The image will be on VP. Since the image is on VP, obviously that point is front view, which is G dash. And 30 mm in front of VP. In front of VP will always come below XY line. So from here, you measure a distance of 30 mm and draw a vertical projector and mark this point as G and show the dimension as 30 mm here. Since it is on HP, so here there will be a possibility of two quadrants. So it is in front of VP. So in front of VP will be in two occasions. One is in the fourth quadrant and the other one is in the first quadrant. Since it is on HP, so if it is above HP, then it becomes first quadrant. If it is below HP, then it becomes fourth quadrant. Therefore, capital G lies in first as well as fourth quadrant. Then capital H on HP and 35 mm behind VP. So take any convenient distance from here to here and draw a vertical projector. On HP means it is on VP. So obviously it will be on XY line and you mark this point as H dash. Then 35 mm behind VP behind VP will be always in above XY line. So behind VP, suppose if it is behind VP, it is above XY line. So from here, you measure a distance of 35 mm and mark this point. So since it is behind VP, so the image will be on HP. Since the image is on HP, obviously that becomes the top view. So you're going to get it as small h. So here, since it is on HP, so again it will going to lie on two quadrant system, that is behind VP, and if it is above HP, then it becomes second quadrant. If it is below HP, then it becomes the third quadrant. Therefore, capital H lies in second as well as third quadrant. This is how we will be able to write the final solution. In the answer, you write capital E lies in third quadrant, capital F lies in fourth quadrant, capital G first lies in first as well as fourth quadrant, and capital H lies in second as well as third quadrant.